Hi viewers, welcome to my channel. In modern days automation system, we are using many controllers, instruments and sensors. Okay, so in that case, PID controller or PID function is the one of the most common known controller used in the automation system, especially in industrial automation and process plants. Okay, so today we will discuss what is PID system or PID function or PID controller. Okay, why we need to use PID controller, where we can use this PID controller, and how it is working, we will discuss in this video. I am Sennappa, welcome to my channel. If you are new to my channel, please do subscribe and support. Okay, so I'm posting many videos related to the topic electrical PLC and automation, even PLC programming. Okay, so if you are interested in those topics, please do watch my previous videos posted. Okay, and please do subscribe and support. In many industries and process plant, okay, if you go and see, we want to do some fulfill some operation, to do some operation or do production, we want to maintain such a units called pressure, temperature and water level. So this kind of all things we want to maintain to do a process in industrial, okay, industrial automation. Okay, that case what we will do, example, for maintaining a pressure in a pipeline, we use water pumps and we will feed the water through the pipe. Okay, so that will be sensed in a process switch will give start command to the starter. The starter will control the motor pumps. Okay, this is the way we are maintaining the pressure. The same case for maintaining the oven temperature or furnace temperature, the same sensor will sense and it will give the signal to the controller. Controller will give the starter to start stop the heaters. Okay, this is how so far we used our in past days we used this electrical control system or automation system to maintain a certain unit. Okay, so those unit you understand. Okay, temperature, pressure or water level. Okay, so this case I will tell you so how this was working and where how PID came into the automation system and how it has helped to solve many things, and it is helped to do the process thing in easiest way, in best way. So before going to into topic, we will discuss something. Okay, so this is normal pressure maintaining system. Okay, you can see one water pump is feeding water to the water line, and the water line one pressure switch is connected. Okay, the pressure switch will sense the pressure level and it will give the signal to the starter panel. The starter panel will give the power cut in cut off to the pump. Okay, to maintain the certain pressure. Okay, in the pressure switch we can set the pressure level. Okay, so based on the setting, the pressure switch will on off and it will give this control signal to the starter. The starter will power up or power down the power down to the motor incoming or motor supply. Okay, so this is how the pressure maintaining system in past days worked. Okay, so the same case when the PID came. Okay, so PID came, so how the system was made. Okay, so how the PID reduced the developed the, or it is helped to achieve or maintain the pressure in best way. Okay, now you can see this block diagram. Okay, same water pipe, same water pump, same water pipe. Instead of pressure switch, we have provided a pressure transmitter. Okay, so and we have added one PID controller. And instead of starter, we have added VFDs. Okay, now same way the pressure transmitter will sense the pressure level and it will give the analog signal to the PID controller. Okay, the PID controller will sense. Okay, in the PID controller we will set a set value. Okay, so based on that set value, the PID controller will give the speed reference to the VFD. The VFD
we'll control the water pipe to maintain the pressure in water line. Okay, so how the VFD will increase and decrease the speed of the pump, and it will manage to maintain the set value pressure. Okay, so this case what will happen, the pressure switch will give the signal to the starter will start stop the pump. Okay, frequently, like when the pressure comes down, the pressure switch will give signal to the starter to start the motor. The start motor will start and it will give it will increase the pressure. Once the pressure increased, again the pressure switch will give the signal to the starter panel. The starter panel will stop the pump. Okay, so there will be a frequently start stop stop the motor. Okay, so what will happen once you do this frequently start stop? First thing, there is a chance of reducing the motor life. Okay, the second thing, frequent start stop, there will be a mechanical vibration, so there is a chance of mechanical damage. The third thing, whenever the pump starts, so it will take starting current. Okay, so per day, if it is start stopping more than 50 times or 60 times or even 40 times, there will be a starting there will be a huge starting current, there is a chance of power loss. Okay, to reduce this all risk factor, the PID has implemented. Okay, PID controller was implemented. Okay, so the PID controller will adjust the speed of the pump to maintain the pressure. Okay, so as I said, the pressure transmitter will monitor the pressure level of the water line. So it will keep on giving it will keep on feeding the pressure level based on that pressure feedback. The PID controller will give signal to the VFD to give the speed reference to control the speed of the pump. Okay, so this case pump will not stop. Okay, either the pump speed will increase or speed will decrease to maintain the pressure in the pipeline. So this is how PID controller is working. Now we will go to the topic. Okay, what is PID controller? PID controller is nothing but proportional integral derivative controller. Okay, in single PID controller consists of three different function or controller. Okay, proportional controller, integral controller, derivative controller. Okay, this is PID controller. Now we will see how PID, what is the PID and how the PID is together controlling, and it will fulfill our requirement through the controller. Okay, and one more information, in this case now when this PID controller was implemented, after that many devices it is coming with inbuilt PID control. Example, VFD, there is inbuilt PID controller. Okay, so instead of this PID controller, we will bypass this one and we will connect this analog pressure transmitter signal directly to the VFD, and we can make the setting in the VFD for PID control, and we can control the pump directly. Okay, even instead of this controller, and PLC also available with the PID blocks. Okay, so through that PLC also we can control, or we can achieve this PID operation. Now we will go to the topic. Now we will see what is PID controller. Okay, so PID controller, as I told, it is proportional integral derivative controller. Okay, in the PID controller there are three different controllers used together. Okay, it's called proportional integral derivative. Okay, so as I told, it is a closed loop feedback mechanism. Okay, this system is working with closed loop feedback mechanism. So as a closed loop feedback mechanism, it delivers the controller output and maintains the measured value. Okay, so it maintains the measured value at set point level. In this PID controller there are two inputs as given. Okay, one is set point. Set point means our desired set point value. Okay, that means here I have shown. Okay, for example, in this pipeline we want to maintain 4 bar of the pressure always, okay, we need 4 bar pressure to be maintained in the pipeline, okay. This pressure sensor is measuring minimum value of 0 and maximum value of 10 bar, okay. So that case, this will give a signal, output signal, when it is measuring 0 bar to 10 bar, it will give 0 volt to 10 volt or 4 to 20 milliampere to the PID controller. So this analog signal to PID controller is the measuring value, okay, as process value, okay. And inbuilt, okay, on the PID controller, we can set the our desired value, okay. Example, now this transmitter is measuring 0 to 10 bar. So our desired or our requirement bar is 4 bar. So in this case, we will set our set point is 4 bar in this PID controller. So the PID controller will keep on monitoring the pipeline pressure. Once the pipeline pressure drops down below 4 bar, this will give the output. This is speed reference, output analog signal to the VFD. Okay. So this will develop the, or this will increase the analog signal level, and it will speed up the VFD. Okay, the VFD will increase the speed of the pump, okay, so that will feed or boost the water into the pipeline. That case, the pressure will develop in the pipeline. The same pressure again will be measured in the pressure transducer, and it will give an analog signal to the PID controller. So from pressure transducer to PID, PID to the VFD, VFD to the pump, pump to the pipeline, again pipeline to the pressure transmitter, and pressure transmitter to the PID controller. So this is how closed loop control system is working, okay. The PID controller will keep on monitoring the pressure level, and it will adjust the speed, okay, increase or decrease to maintain the 4 bar, which is our desired set point, okay. So this is the best, or this is the main function of PID, okay. This is how PID system is working, okay. Now see, again we came to the point topic, okay. If there is any difference between the set point and measured value, the PID algorithm performance mathematical calculation and a corresponding corrective signal is applied to the process. So as I explained, if there is any changes in the pressure, so that will reflect to this pressure transmitter signal. The same will be sensed in the PID controller, and it will adjust the output of the PID out. Now we will see how the PID function blocks or PID controller is working, okay. We have one sample in one PLC function block diagram, okay. Here we have used one PID block. We will see how the system is working, how it will monitor the inputs, and it will control the output of the PID or output of the system. Now we have one digital input which will enable from field, okay, so that means auto, and we have one input from pressure transmitter which will measure the pipeline pressure 0 to 10 bar, and accordingly it will give the signal to 0 to 10 volt, okay. And we have PID block, okay. Here we can see PID, okay, proportional gain, an integral timer, derivative timer, okay, and desired set point. So now our pressure transducer will give 0 to 10 bar reference as a 0 to 100 decimal value, okay. So that case we want to maintain 5 bar, so I have put 50, okay. So 50 means that case it has to maintain 5 bar pressure in the pipeline, okay. Here the action direct or reverse, okay. Now we want to use direct PID. So if you want to know what is direct PID or reverse PID, I have posted one video related to this topic in my playlist, you can watch that, okay. Here output, you need analog or digital pulse with modulating system. So now we need analog, okay. This is the simplest system settings we made. Now we will check by simulating. Run. Okay, now we'll start. Now our there is no pressure in the pipeline. We assume there is no pressure in pipeline, so the pressure transmitter is giving zero. Okay, the same time the output also started to increase to develop the pressure in the pipeline. The output will be 0 to 10 volt to the VFD. The VFD will run, or it will increase the decrease the speed based on this output. Okay, now VFD, assume VFD started and it is start controlling the pump. The pump is feeding the water to the pipeline. The pressure is increasing. Okay, so when the pressure is increasing, the transmitter will give the pressure input, so the input value will increase. Our set point is 50. So once these values reached near 50, that means 5 bar, the output is stopped. Okay, you can see, and also it is started reducing also. Once the pressure goes little beyond the set point level, the output you'd reducing. Okay, you can see once the pressure decrease very quickly, the output also decreasing very quickly. Okay, now the output is decreasing. Once the pressure drops down below the set point, again the output will increase and it will try to maintain the our desired set point pressure on the pipeline. Okay, and also this is not only used in the maintaining the pressure, okay, in pumps application. So this is an example. Okay, so this PID control can be used in maintaining the temperature also. Instead of VFD, we can use thyristor. You can give the analog input to the thyristor. You can control the heating level of the heaters also. Okay, and temperatures. Temperature means heat as well as cold. Okay, cooling also we can control. Okay, the main advantage of this PID controller is, as I told, it will reduce the electricity consumption and also mechanical damage and life of the equipment. Okay, I hope you understand this topic related to PID controllers. Okay, so how it is working, where we need to use this, and how we can utilize this PID controller in our automation system. Okay, so if you have any doubt related to this, please let me know through comment, and also please subscribe if you are first time my channel. Okay, this is how you can support my channel, and I will share the many automation information related to switchgear and PLC, okay, in future videos. Okay, thanks for watching. We will meet in next video. Till then, bye from Sinappa.